In today's video, I want to share a new technique you can use in Affinity Photo. This only became possible with the recent launch of Affinity Photo 2. It involves processing a RAW file twice and then combining the two versions together. I'll start by opening the RAW file that I want to use for this. What caught my attention when I shot this image was the contrast between the bright yellow of the sun and the blue of the clouds on the left. Now when I come to process the image, we don't really see this transition. This is an ideal situation to use the double RAW processing technique. My first step is to correct the image tones. To do this, I'll increase the black point to around 5% because the darkest tones are too light. This makes the image quite dark, so I'll then increase the shadows to around 60%. After that, I can reduce the highlights to about 40% to prevent the bright sky from becoming blown out. This creates a reasonable histogram, allowing me to use the contrast slider, increasing it to around 10%. And before I forget, I'll just set the profile for this image to be Adobe RGB. These changes have improved the image tones, but the colours are still looking muddy. Neither the yellow on the right or the blue on the left look particularly strong. What I'm going to do is first produce a version of this image for the stronger yellow sky. All I need to do is increase the temperature by a couple of clicks. This makes the yellow stronger in the clouds and on the sand, but at a cost to the blue sky. To make this easier to see in the video, I'll increase the vibrance to about 30%. The final change I want to make is to add some sharpening to this image. Having applied a basic set of adjustments to the image, I want to develop it and switch to the photo persona. But before I do this, I also need to check to make sure that the output is set to be a raw layer, and I want to use the embedded option. Now I can click the develop button. Back in the photo persona, I can see the newly developed layer in the Layers Studio panel. My next step is to duplicate the layer by right-clicking and picking the duplicate option. I can then rename the layer to be blue because I want to use this layer to enhance the blue in the image. Next, I can open the duplicate layer in the photo persona by double-clicking it. Because this is a duplicate raw layer, it has the same settings as the layer it was copied from. To strengthen the blue, I'll reduce the colour temperature slightly. I should also point out that this technique isn't only for use with colour. You can adjust the raw development in any way you want. For example, let's increase the clarity to 15% because it seems to emphasise the blue a little more. And because I'm doing this for the video, let's increase the saturation to around 15% to make the effect more obvious. When I've finished adjusting the copy raw layer, I can click the develop button and return to the photo persona. We now have two raw layers in the Layers Studio, but developed with different settings. When I hide the top layer, you can see how different it is to the lower layer. Next, I want to create a layer mask to combine the two images together. First, I'll click the blue layer to select it. Then I'll click the new mask option icon and pick the Hue Range Mask. Let's turn on the preview so you can see the mask. The white areas of the mask reveal the top layer in the image, whilst the black areas hide it. The four dots on the colour wheel represent the colours being selected in the mask. Any colours that appear between the two middle dots on the colour wheel are selected. At the moment, this is selecting the orange area of the sky. If I drag them clockwise, it changes to select more of the yellow. Now let's move it around to the blue area because it's the blue of the top layer we want to be visible. If I turn off the preview, you can see the difference this is now making. What the two outer dots do is just help blend the adjustment. If we don't need a precise mask to blend the two layers together as in this image, we can also use the blur slider at the bottom to help with blending. If I turn on the preview again, you can see what's happening. Let's close this now because I want to refine the image further. The first thing I want to do is reopen the blue layer in the develop persona because the settings are just a little bit too strong. Now that I'm back in the develop persona, there's something else I want to highlight. What you're seeing in the display isn't just the blue layer, you're seeing the two raw layers combined in a preview. You can use this to fine-tune any adjustments you make. To make this image a little bit more believable, I'll reduce the saturation to zero and the vibrancy to around 15%. I'll also increase the colour temperature slightly to around 5000. That's now looking like a better blend of the colours between the two layers. I can then click the Develop button to return to the photo persona. If I hide the bottom layer, you can see the parts of the blue layer being included in the image. And if I hide the top layer, you can see how it improves the blue. This is looking better, but I'm not entirely happy with the blending between the two layers. I think that the cutoff between the blue and the yellow isn't subtle enough. Also, I'd like more of the yellow clouds on the left to be visible. What I'm going to do is add a new mask layer to the blue layer. I can now use the paintbrush tool to paint black onto the mask to reveal the yellow in the clouds. It also helps with the blending of the two layers to make it appear more natural. This is an extremely flexible approach because Affinity Photo 2 has made it non-destructive. For example, if I open the range mask again, I can remove the blur I applied and I can change the colour selection. Then if I want to strengthen the orange in the image, I can double-click the background layer to increase the saturation. I can now return to the photo persona to make any further changes I want. This technique just wasn't possible in the previous version of Affinity Photo. Something else you can do with this technique for even more control is combine it with blend ranges. Let's select the blue layer and then click the cog icon to open the blending options. The source layer is the layer I currently have selected in the Layer Studio panel, so I'm going to use that control. I can then drag the point over on the right down to the bottom. This prevents the blue layer from showing in any of the brightest areas of the image. If you want to know more about how to use the blend ranges control, watch this video next. It explains how this control works in detail. Thanks for watching today, and I hope you've enjoyed the video. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I hope to see you soon for another video.